Well, it looks pretty good.
I'll go ahead and take the take that off. 36 inch clamp come in handy. Got a good solid joint. That's good. I'm going to go ahead and put our screw in it. I'm going to use a Craig screw. This is 1.5. Get a longer one. There we go. There we go. I like those Craigs because they don't split the wood. Alright, with the bolt in there, our next step is to go ahead and glue on the soundboard. And get the glue to come out. Don't want to put too much glue on it. Get our soundboard on. This got a knot in the back. I thought maybe putting a knot in the front just to make it look cool, and then put it in the back. So I don't know what I'll do with it. I think I'll just leave it in the back. There we go. Get it lined up best I can. There we go. Break out the little wheel vices. These are the best little vices, man. I like that. They're cheap. They work. One more. There we go. That's it. She's all done up. So now I just let that dry while that's sitting. Move on to something else. All right, for the bridge, I took a piece of walnut, and we got our gap right here, and I stood it up and marked it with a pencil. And I'm gonna cut that about 1/8 longer, right, and put it up there, because right there it comes up perfect flat. But we want the bridge just a little bit higher than the fretboard, but there's fretless, so. But that is the fretboard. So let's try to cut it. I glued a piece of hardwood on that just to make it a little bit easier to hold. Sometimes holding it's the hard part. Clamp that down, but too late now. Let me make sure I'm not sawing the thing. That'd suck. That would suck. Almost there. Got it. All right. Here we go. Can't see it very well, but it is higher than higher than the bridge. We'll have to file that down. Next is all. Where I want my strings? I think I want it right here. There we go. Yep. I don't know where to file down my the holes for the strings. going to need to be deeper than that. We'll start with those and we'll fine tune them later once we get the strings on. I'm going to use a little super glue and glue the nut on because we might have to knock it off later if I don't like it, or if I can't control the buzzing, then we might have to switch to a different nut. Next, we'll just figure out where we're going to put the tuners at. So you want the tuner a little on the side of the strings, where the string's going to be, you know, there's the center string there. So we want this tuner about right here. Then we got the string over here. And we want this tuner. You got to give them enough room so they can turn, they won't hit each other. So we're about right here, but we want this one to be farther up. We'll put this one over here. Yeah, put this one up right here. I think this will be far enough. Yeah. Do, 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 do. It's going to be where our tuners will go. Like I said, you want it to have enough room to where they won't hit. That might not be. Yeah, that's enough room. I have one left, man. Okay, they come in packs of four, so I use the one left and make a bow diddly or something. It's gonna be layout. Next, we'll drill our holes for our pegs. Pretty even.